Fight away as you can see, this is a pretty tight yard, and now I'm going to have to get round that corner there. So let's see how we do. Swing it over to the right. Watch for the fence, watch for the red car, watch for the trees on this side, watch for any traffic coming from up there. And away we go. Nobody ever stops coming the other way down here. Fair enough, they've got right of way. But this would make it easier if they let me through. Because now, as you can see behind, they're stuck until I move. And I bet this car comes through now. I've got my headlights on. They should be able to see me coming. So it's going to have to back up now, that car. Nobody ever seems to think there'll be something coming the other way. Right, I'm still en route to Middlesbrough for something to eat and an needed to have a break anyway, so I had no choice in the matter really. So maybe another hour. We'll be at Middlesbrough. Weather's looking a bit better, but to say it won't start snowing again the further north we go. Because once I've done the delivery at Middlesbrough, it's over the tops into Cumbria and drop down into Carlisle. And then from Carlisle up into Scotland and up to Clydebank, just north of Glasgow. I get that done today. If not, I think the Clydebank delivery might be first thing tomorrow morning. But basically, this is Middlesbrough. That flyover cut through the town centre. I think it's a town, I don't think it's a city. I don't know whether you saw the football ground off to the left-hand side and the bridge. It tends to be all chemicals and containers. So you're not really missing anything if you've never been to Middlesbrough. Ugh. this next place, you've got to reverse down off this road 200 or 300 yards round the side of the building. Problem is, it's right next to the learner driver test centre. And as you can imagine, they don't really like giving way. And bend up here, which is a bit awkward as well for traffic coming around the bend, but no choice, no way in. That beep is just because I took my seatbelt off. I've got to reverse up there where he's turning out. I've got a learner there, a learner there, and a learner there. To let me through. It's not stopping all the learners coming out though. Well, now I've got to try and reverse through that gate and round that corner. And that's the view on this side, and that's the view on that side. No view really. See, that's how close I am on this side now, and obviously I've got a red car down that side and I can't even see it. I've just jumped out, had a quick look, and as long as I stay straight now, I've missed it. And then you find someone else has gone and dumped another car there. Bit of messing, but it's always worth jumping out, double checking, especially that, because it was a blindside reverse round that corner through those gates. Would have been a lot easier obviously in a left hand drive vehicle, or if the gates were on the other side. Can you see how close that red car is to the gates? That's the one I couldn't see, and I didn't want to risk banging that one. Now I've got to get as far as I can over here, because the stuff that's coming off here 20 feet long. I need to get over as far as I can so we can lift it off. And one thing I didn't mention is this isn't an easy trucking job, because I've got to go and unload them myself now. Now, unexpectedly, the battery ran out then, just before I'd finished. But, yeah, another thing about reversing in this yard, the fact that the trailer-mounted forklift truck's on the back as well doesn't make it any easier. It's not too bad, as long as you allow for that little bit extra distance. Problem is, you can't see it when you're reversing at all. You might have also noticed the little 7.5 tonner that turned up just before I started unloading. He turned up, the shutters opened, they took that delivery in, obviously saw me, went back in, pulled the shutters back down. That's the problem with this job, you're left to your own devices, no one cares about you. Most folk are nice enough when you meet them, but they don't want anything to do with you when you turn up with a delivery. So literally, I mean, you saw the boxes flying off due to the wind, but you know, the guys are pleasant enough in there. But you know, it's now probably about 12 o'clock, so on a normal working day, I suppose most of you watching, I'd be getting ready to clock off after doing 8 hours. I was up at 3 a.m, 3 o'clock this morning. Was in the yard at 4, so started at 4. It's now 12. So that's 8 hours already. And I've still got to travel from Middlesbrough across to Carlisle and then probably up to Glasgow, which, you know, anything from between 11 and 15 hours is a regular day. So for anybody that think truck drivers have it easy, it's well, some maybe do, but you know, if you're working between 11 15 hours a day doing all the unloading yourself, fair enough. I've stopped for a break this morning, but I suppose in any shift of 8 hours, most people maybe have 15 minutes in the morning, half an hour for the dinner, another 15 minutes in an afternoon. But yeah, I'll just wait for this van to move that's parked next to me, and then we'll make tracks to the next delivery. Could do with a brew as well, but nobody even asked you if you're thirsty or you want a brew. But each to their own, I suppose.